What you are about to see is an episode of Comedy After Dark. This was a TV show that aired in Connecticut 1992 to 1994 and starred high school friends. There was no high definition then. We shot the show on VHS tape. The old tapes broke down over time, leaving some episodes with poor video quality.
Everybody's here.
Are they getting ready to start the music?
Yeah. You better hurry up.
Damn it.
Hurry up.
Damn it! Take my hair. I gotta put the makeup on. I gotta shave, comb the hair, put on a jacket. I'm not ready. All right.
Studio 1 in Northford, Connecticut. It's Comedy After Dark, starring Mike Burke.
Jason and Zach. Jason Tucker, Jen Lassen, and Chad Blanchard. Plus me, I'm Lawrence D.
And now, everyone at home, turn off your lights, turn off your sets, snuggle up and get cozy. Here he is, the man himself, the godfather of comedians, the Great
Oh, I want to thank everyone for that no applause I got.
Thank you. I know you're just taking it for...
You guys really know how to make a person laugh and feel comfortable. Please, just be... Stop it! Thank you very much. Thanks. Be seated, please. Please, sit down. Enough! No. Stop bowing, please. Put your clothes back on. Thank you. Thank you very much for giving me that warm applause and letting me into your homes right now. Right now, I am in your living room, bedroom, family room, garage, kitchen, wherever else you watch the TV, bathroom. It's very quiet in here today because there's hardly anybody here. We all had a... That'll be enough of that noise. I'm trying to do a goddamn monologue here.
Cut it out.
But there won't be... You want me to walk right out now? Because if I see stuff like that happening again, I'm out of here. I've had enough of people doing things like that. So let's get to some comedy stuff. You ever watch... You see these movies on, say, HBO, where they swear a lot. And then they go to... ABC, NBC, or CBS, and then what they do is they fill in... What the hell was that? I heard... They fill in words, you know, for the swears, but they usually don't do it the right way. I mean, sometimes they'll fill in, so they'll be like, excuse me, get the hell out of here. Or, if you watch where they do a bad job, it'll be sort of like this.
I'm telling you right now, get the hell out of here! I'm tired of you coming into my...
Stupid.
House! Get out!
I'm not even going to do a monologue. No one's paying attention. Everyone's just like...
I'll listen to you, Mike.
But should I laugh? Maybe I shouldn't.
All right, anyway, let's stop that swearing. I don't feel like anything swears up today, you moron, you geek. Okay. Now I have to edit out this whole thing. I'm tired of editing. People like that! Okay. So another thing I can do now is I could just do impressions. You all want to hear that?
Sure.
Thanks for that enthusiastic sure.
Yes!
I remember once when I was a boy, Chris is alive. Oh. Jerry Seinfeld. How many people know who Jerry Seinfeld is?
Me.
You all know him?
Yeah.
Jay Leno! What kind of a name is Jay Leno? You could pronounce it Jay Leno! Jay Leno! Who gave him that last name? Does anybody know? Why? Why is his name Leno? Leno! Sounds like something you call for Leno! Why? Why do they do that? How many people know Richard Pryor?
Me.
Me.
You want to know? Right.
You back there that got burned because you're short and cracked.
Yep, and the guy who's almost... he's dying now, I think it is. He's got some cancer or something like that. Richard Pryor. Well, first you gotta do the walk. Can't forget that walk.
Oh! Why is so dick, right? Who's in this? What is that? See, flying like a skull. God, this stupid little piece of skull is crying. I'm gonna take my hand and wrap around your throat. What are you doing? No! Oh, I'm gonna get my arms and I'm gonna kill you! This golly thing. Guys, what drives me wrong? Why are you thinking doing this? Look at, look, you pissed on my shoe. You pissed on the stars. I'm trying to kill you.
Thank you, lady. Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you. That killed my heart right now.
Bill Cosby.
Anybody
know Bill Cosby?
Yep.
Pudding Puck.
No, good morning.
Let's see, what other voices haven't I done in this show? Never. Gilbert Godfrey. How many people know
oh,
who he is?
God.
Oh,
you all know who this guy
yeah.
is?
Yeah.
What is this here? Who? All these people sit there looking at me. Why did you receive it, huh? Someone said I look like a Chinese guy. I'm not Chinese. I just look like it, huh? What are you doing?
Dead silence here. Anybody else? I'm gonna kill this
How
kid.
How about Mike Burke?
I'm gonna kill Lawrence Dagley. In my classes, the kid, I say something, the kid does this. I'm gonna kill him! Alright, anybody else? We're gonna go now. We got a great show for you.
Yes. Oh, I shut it off. It's not great. We have a great show today, I think. I don't know. We haven't filmed it yet. So, we'll be back in a moment. Here's the band.
The band, you see? We are the band. There's it right over there. Don't that be bad.
Sit there.
No, no, remember? I sit here.
All right.
Remember?
Yeah, go ahead.
All right, remember? So, we had a good show today.
Oh, wait a minute. I'm the host. Get out of there.
Damn.
Jesus. That's a comfortable chair, actually.
I know.
Maybe we should put the couch and have that as the guest chair. Okay, welcome. How you doing, Chad?
Hey, what's up? Sorry
welcome
to
back.
Barge back in.
Oh, that's okay.
What's going on?
This place is open to everybody. Except Robert Liston and Kennedy.
Yeah.
Okay.
welcome, ladies and gentlemen. We have a special surprise here. Chad is back for a free. Look at this. Chad Blanchard, ladies and gentlemen. Yes. See, we have special guests on this show every week. Yes. Chad Blanchard.
Give it up, Chad.
Okay. All right, we have a nice show today, I think. I don't know. Like I said before, we haven't done it yet. How would I know?
Mike Burke from 1998. I'm sorry to interrupt the program. We had a problem with this episode when we shot it. Of course, one problem, I couldn't speak English. We haven't bringed out Lawrence in a while. It's brought you, idiot. But anyways, during this episode, we recorded the show on a bad videotape. I tried to save most of it in the original edit of this episode, but as I watch it back now, it's not that great. You'll notice that there will be white lines going across the screen, flashing, that my voice at times will sound like this. Ladies and gentlemen, Lawrence Degley. And our weekend news with Lawrence Degley is in yap speed. I left it in because it's kind of funny. He was interviewing Marlon Brando over a case of the cue card boy who got beaten up by Marlon Brando. This beaten up thing was kind of becoming a weekly tradition. Jack Nicholson beats up a waiter, and Chelsea Clinton beats up Jack Nicholson, and Clint Eastwood beats up Bob Dylan. It was just a regular feature on the show. But anyways, it's all in yap speed, so if you're wondering why that's all screwed up. But I don't know how much of this show is actually in good shape. Most of it may not be. So I apologize for that. We now return back to this very unusual show, where half the time I'm talking like this. So here it is, back to Comedy After Dark.
Lawrence Degley, ladies and gentlemen.
How you doing, Mike?
I'm doing just fine.
What do you think of the new chair? Why don't you explain to the people at home why the hell the chair broke again?
There go Lorette.
Yeah, Mike. I know Lorette there. Go ahead, Lorette.
All right, all right. Ah, that's good.
That's good.
No bait.
Where were we? Alright, shut up. Could you fix that one? Shut up. Mike, there's something else.
Is this supposed to be getting in front of the desk?
What?
Is this supposed to be getting in front of the desk?
What do you mean, the front of the desk?
Am I supposed to just get your heads and bodies? Torsos.
No, you get the whole thing. Did you move it all the way back?
No.
I mean, not the kid. Why don't you explain? Okay, explain why our bench is broken.
Oh, because,
Our couch, actually, that I spent hours building.
Because everybody jumped on it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What do we say to people like that?
Boo!
Okay. Now, how many chairs have we had? Let's go through each
16.
One.
16. Uh-oh, someone's keeling out.
I'm sorry, that was my cat.
Oh.
I don't have a cat.
I don't blame you.
Okay, let's see. Chair number one was a chair. It's a big chair. As a matter of fact, the sides to this couch here, did you get that, Carl? Carl on the camera today, was part of our first chair. Yeah. Our second chair was,
That bench right there.
A bench I made. Remember I built that wooden bench?
Oh, the
first
wooden bench painted gray.
Yes. Wooden bench painted gray. That was the second one. What happened? Someone jumped out and broke it. Our third chair, which is over in our audience now, we had that one.
That bench.
That bench. That one lasted for a very long time. But what happened to that one? Charlie Chaplin just ran in.
That broke when that someone sat on it.
Yeah, the chair. Oh, well, I was doing Mary Jo Buttafuoco, I think it was. The head club, and I had a stroke, and boom, the bench broke. So that one broke. So then we fixed that one up. We kept it for a while, but it kept leaning, and it was too small, and it didn't look good. So we got rid of that.
Yeah.
Then we got this very long couch, but it was too big.
So I put that in my room. And we got this guy.
Now we got this. I built this one, and this one broke. And then also a while back we had a temporary chair with a table in the middle.
The history of our couch.
The girl talk thing
Michael
was done
Burke.
On. Yeah. So let's say this right now. Show them what kind of people we are. There won't be any
none, nothing, whatever, ain't, that's been added to the dictionary now. Yep. Ain't is a word, so if your English teacher says ain't is not a word, say, screw you, it is. There ain't, there's not, there will not be no Beavis and Butthead on this show.
That's right.
Nothing. Yeah. Yes, you know why? Because
they suck.
They're terrible.
Because what happened?
They suck.
Carl Peterson started it, the trend. He was like the only one who said it. And then everybody else had to get in, and now everybody else is doing that. So now it's everywhere, and now everyone's going to get sick of me. I'm tired, and eventually die a slow, miserable death.
I'm
like,
glad,
like me right now.
No, you're not dying.
I'm dying a miserable death right now.
You're dying.
What are we going to do today?
I got an idea.
Yes.
Wait a
second. Oh, first, look at this here. Look at this. Look at that.
Shalom. Oh! Shalom. Peace.
Well, that kind of screws the whole joke now.
I know, nice job.
Well, it was a newspaper, so I ripped it in half. It was the New Haven Register, and on the front it says, peace.
Shalom, peace.
Peace.
Shalom.
What happened was this week, on Monday, September something.
September 13th.
Yeah. They signed the peace treaty. Now,
yep.
There's this one guy here. He does not look too thrilled to be shaking the hand of Yasser Arafat.
Very true.
What kind of a name is that? Yasser! You feeling good today? Yasser! Yasser, Arafat. I mean, Jesus Christ. Yasser. Let me tell you, you want to sign peace? Yasser. And the last name, Arafat. That sounds like some kind of a new fat. It's like, you know, aerodynamic fat. Arafat. Yasser. Yasser, Arafat. Yasser. Okay. Well, what's my guy?
Huh?
George?
Yeah.
Lumpy!
Shut up, man. Okay.
Of course.
Well, this here, look at this. I am king.
Here you are.
Nah, that's not funny.
I know.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Burke House. Okay, today what we're going to do, and I want everyone to participate. To be a pop, to
join in.
Okay, I want everyone to participate.
Participate.
I want everyone to participate.
Foliage.
I know his name. Shut up.
Lumpy.
Shut up.
Now, I want everyone to participate in this skit. Not really a skit, but a little thing we're doing. First of all, when I was moving that desk, it made sort of this sound. You ever sitting in school and you're on your chair, and it's happened to everybody, and you make like a sound like this? From the chair itself. You ever get that? Like, say you're moving your desk and it moves a little bit and it goes. Don't you feel like an idiot? So what do? You do it again. And you keep doing it just so people think that it was just a desk. You ever worry about that, huh?
Yeah, absolutely. Always.
Or your stomach. You ever get the growling stomach? And it goes. Or whatever it does is. I wanna eat. Shut up.
You shut up.
Okay, this here, I'm taking a class in school called theater arts. No, it's teaches you things about acting and stuff like that. And
yep.
I've learned a lot. But I was reading through it.
Yeah.
Because I was bored.
Yeah.
And they have things in here that you do before you do a show.
Yeah.
Or a play or a movie
yeah.
or.
Yeah.
You shut up.
No.
You shut up, you play with crap. Okay. So this here, what will be the first one we'll do?
The relaxation body warm-ups.
Okay, so I want everyone to participate in this. These are, and I'm going to show you what these are like. Me and Lawrence will demonstrate because we practiced these before the show. Ragdoll. What you do with this thing is, well, let's demonstrate it.
Okay.
This is called ragdoll. Let's go to the stage over there.
Okay, we're going to the stage.
We're
going
to go to the stage to do some of these.
Is this the stage?
That's the stage.
This is the stage?
That's the stage.
This is the stage?
Shut up, that's the stage.
You shut up.
You shut up.
You shut up.
No, you.
So you.
Okay.
Hey, thank you, Larry.
Okay, this here.
What happened?
I don't know. Well, this here is.
I don't want to hit these lights.
All right.
You know how I am.
Okay, let's put this here.
Okay, let's.
All right, what we're going to do for this one, move, spread yourself out. This here is called the ragdoll. They actually, people actually do this. People like Clint Eastwood do these things. You ready for this?
Yeah,
just
ready.
Go behind the light.
Yeah, okay.
What is it? They actually call this the ragdoll. I'm supposed to do this like 10 or 20. Everyone get up. Come on. Get your lazy selves
come
up.
On,
Jesus
everybody.
Christ.
Six, seven,
okay.
Eight.
You do this. Everyone demonstrate.
And what? And do.
No, okay. You're supposed to stretch tall with your feet spread out perfectly. And then what you're supposed to do is suddenly just relax, just like this. And then you come up slowly and do something. Well, you gotta keep your legs standing up there.
Oh.
Yeah.
Okay.
I know when you go to bed at night and just like to fall in the bed, you're like, I'm tired. And then you're gone, you're sleeping. Okay, so that's what you're supposed to do, ready?
Telephone!
Got it!
Okay.
Welcome to the missionary. Ready? And go.
Oh, it's like headbanging.
Exactly.
I feel drunk.
Okay, there's that one. Okay.
That was cool.
Some of them are really crazy and fun.
I think I'm stuck.
Head roll. You've all done this before.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, you do this thing. You just go.
I feel.
Ah, mess up.
Ah!
It's like you're drunk.
Okay, you got that one. Arm swing.
Yeah!
It's something like that. The yawn. They actually yawn, too. They actually have people... Chewbacca yawn. Oh, Chewie! Chewie, it's a little cold here, Chewie! Luke, Vader, Father, it's you! Father, it's you and Vader! Luke, you must find the Jedi, Luke!
Okay, what
else?
Just twist it.
Okay. Oh, this is pretty stupid and tricky. It's called the rhythm hop. They actually do this. All right, I think I remember this well. All right, you do this. Left foot.
Mike Burke will make
that
it.
Out
sure.
And do this. All right, they actually do.
Hey, kids, welcome to Perry's Playhouse.
This is fun.
Sounds like an Italian thing. You ever see the Italian thing?
Russian!
Ah! Somebody
broke. Sure. Another chair.
Another one. How about this one here? This one here.
Sorry, Bob.
Oh, I know. This one here. You got. There's actually one that goes like this. You ready for this? Let me see. Yeah, actually goes. Jump up and do that. You ready? Everyone do it. Come on. Okay. Or this one here. You're supposed to kick, you jump up and kick it, and then you fly in the air like, all right.
Oh, God.
Hey.
Yeah.
I know. Hell. It's like one of those.
Every time he comes here, he breaks something.
There's no hope for that anymore, Mike.
What? What's going on? Another one! The chairs! Every single chair on this show breaks! I've had a bench behind my chair. I was once sitting on it like, what was there? I don't think we weigh that much. I mean, why? I don't know. It's going to puke all over the floor.
No budget.
Okay, what else is this? What's the other one? Oh, yeah, you're supposed to sing. And it actually says this in here. Nursery rhymes while you do this thing. You're supposed to say, Mother Goose, Mother Goose, whatever. How does it go?
Little boy Blue, he needed the money.
The cow jumped over the moon.
I mean, you said like one of
those. Okay. Mouse ran up
Tug of
cock.
War. This one's good. I like this one.
Come on, Lord, you know what to do. This.
You actually... Yeah. You actually make it look like you're pulling a rope.
What a
dumb. And you get into it, so it's kind of like.
You get the rope?
Yeah.
You got the rope?
You got it?
You got the rope?
Go!
You got the rope? You got the rope? You got the rope? Get the harder. Shit. Yeah.
Broke.
Yeah,
broke,
it.
Broke.
Okay.
Think I got rope, bro.
You got this one, everyone's done this in gym class, the fake jump rope. Play sport. Oh, you pretend you're playing a sport. Like,
ready? I'm pitching.
Walk. Hit the batter.
Try to make it more realistic.
Okay. The balloon
bro.
Catch is something that was done when you have LSD.
And how do we constitute the balloon catch?
With the balloon catch, you're supposed to make it like you're trying to catch the balloon, it's going away.
Yeah.
But this happens during when people have drugs and LSD. So basically, it's nothing new to them. So... This is like a stair thing. You just wait there, I'll be right back. Just videotape this and I'll show it to you. It's sort of something like, we just kind of like...
Ow.
Actually, it wasn't supposed to go like that. I was actually supposed to like... Never mind. Let's just go back to the dance.
Hey, Mike.
Don't
you hate it when this happens, when you're going upstairs and like you, every now and again you go upstairs, you're not paying attention, and you don't go quite high enough to go like that, and you're like, ugh!
Oh, that's horrible.
Doesn't that suck? You're just like, ugh!
Oh, yeah.
Don't you hate that? I do that in school all the time.
Or you're walking down the
sidewalk. I know, that's true. You're in school, yeah, that's right.
Or you're walking down the sidewalk trying to impress a bunch of girls and there's that one piece of sidewalk wedged up and you
pop
flat
out
of your face.
Yeah,
or this. You see somebody up there, they say, how you doing? Yeah. Skip
or do you ever know sometimes when you think there's actually another stair? So you go out and you're just like, ah!
You know, that's right, yeah.
It's really annoying. Or
no, you know, stuff like that happens.
Who moved
the stairs? Who moved the
We're so twisted, it's unbelievable.
That is true though, in school, you're walking behind someone and then you're just like, kinda like...
What about the water?
God damn, it's gonna break.
I really hate this!
That really sucks. Fucked me up.
I'm stuck in these damn stairs right now.
Hand him his mic.
Okay.
This is Mike Burke's mic.
Actually,
that's Paul Mele's mic. That's just shit that we're gonna destroy before we get to
you. You know what? I think I just broke my ass. Let's go to the desk.
It's much more safe.
Landing over there sometime soon?
I hate to look at my jack. Oh,
what
my
happened?
God.
Huh?
What happened?
I told you, I asked you anything.
Okay, Lars, come back to the,
All right.
Desk there.
Okay.
Okay.
God damn.
I don't think that'll happen. Okay. All right. Well, I'm going to sit down now and we'll get started. Who moved the chair? Lawrence, how many times do you have to do that? Sorry.
No, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to move the chair.
Why don't you shut up, Okay. Now. Let's get back to the show. Voice, disgusting pig. These are called voice warm-ups, and I have to do this because, you know, I have those impressions, and, well, this is called the smile pucker. That's right, pucker. What you do with this is, you do this. Watch my face. You try this in a moment. You go, let's see. Okay, you go like this, and you say, like you're sharing cheese, you know? And you have to sit there and talk like this. And you try to show it all the way to your face, really good. Now, why don't you try that? You do it. Do it. Here, there you go. Now say, don't teachers kick you in the ass for that? Okay, this next one is, then with exaggeration. Pucker in between your lips, and then say, it sounds like a gorilla, people do this, this is not a joke, and then you say these words too, I don't even talk like this. What is it, baby talk? Feel comfortable now? I told you not to eat my hair. Tongue tip. This is how you're supposed to touch, make your tongue touch your nose, and then you're supposed to make your tongue touch your chin. Then you do that. And
enough with the Gene Simmons thing already.
I know.
I'll be out of the Oh yeah, kind of. You call up the museum. You curl up your tongue and try to touch the back of your throat. Okay, now you push out your right cheek. Oh, you've done this before, you know, one of these things. So you do that. You move your tongue. It's tongue exercise. That's the throat. Look at this. I can make this pen look like rubber. Isn't that nice?
Pretty
cool!
Whoa!
Whoa!
Pretty cool, man.
Whoa. The trash.
Okay, now. Now we go to new, now we do some better things. You have tongue twisters. I want you all to try these. Two teams are trying to steal 22 keys! Two teams are trying to steal 22 keys! You got that one?
Yep.
How to do that one? You got that one? You got it. All right, say that, everyone.
Two teams are trying to steal 22 keys!
Two teamsters tried to steal 22 keys.
Two
teamsters tried to steal 22 keys.
Two teamsters
tried to
steal 22
keys. Woozily. 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 Okay. Opera's always come with green albums in the autumn.
Okay.
She makes a proper cup of coffee in the proper drink. Much willing water makes the milk go beatless happen. Okay.
The microwave. Okay. He's doing an impression of the micro-machine man.
Okay, let's see. Do this. Oh, you've all, how many people have done this? Oh, and you do it as long as you can. Ready? Everyone try this.
You ready? Go!
Batter up. Next one. Okay. Gibberish. Me and Lawrence will carry out a conversation in gibberish. This is another thing that happens.
I got it.
Ready for this?
Sold to the man in the blue hat.
There you go.
Oh, go.
Singing.
Got her.
Singing. You were an
asshole. Don't swear on the show. That's an edit.
I'm gonna take her out and eat it.
Go ahead, you jerk.
Bite me, you mother. And when I break you, I'll kick your ass.
I'm tired of you swearing.
This is a pen, I'll shove it up your ass.
You
hold on, 10 pages.
Welcome
to the show today. My name's Mike Burke. This is your game, Lawrence. He looks like kicked up. Okay, there you go. I can't believe I just sang. Now, ladies and gentlemen, this is great. I like it. You say this sentence in different ways here. Okay, we're going to say, now let's do it. There goes the last one. Sternly, there goes the last one. Frightened. There goes the last one! Eagerly. There goes the last one!
Definitively!
What does it mean? Like a statement.
There goes
the last one!
That's it, like you're thinking.
Soothingly!
There goes the last one.
Shyly.
There goes the last one.
Loudly.
Dubiously.
What does that mean?
Doobie Brothers.
Dubiously.
And like really confident.
Isn't that
confident? There goes the last one.
Doobie Brothers.
Drowsily.
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 Like we're doing this whole show.
There goes the last one. Like the show. Wistfully. There goes the last one. Joyfully. There goes the last one. Airily, they call it. There goes the last one.
Marilynly.
That's right. Jack Nicholsonly. There goes the last one. And there's much more here. Stunt. There goes the last one. Okay, anyway. This here, I like this one. Say, what are you doing as though you were a wild woman?
What are you doing? Oh, no.
Just learning to read. Talking to a cute puppy.
What are you doing? Oh, what are you doing?
Talking, a preacher saying, what are you doing?
What are you doing?
Talking to a deaf person.
What are you doing? You! What are you doing?
The game show host.
A burly policeman.
What are you doing?
Dictating it to his secretary. What are you doing? What are you doing? A fond young husband to his wife. What are you doing? A frightened child.
Leave me alone, stop molesting me.
What do you think, huh?
Very good.
Yeah.
Very good. Very good.
okay. There's one more thing.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to
mention the purpose of today's show is this is part one of our Murder After Dark 3-week movie thing. That's right. This week is part one, which we already filmed.
Yep.
Why don't you explain it, because I've been talking about it.
Okay, this is part one. We already filmed it. It was about murder after dark. The cast members were in it because it was a great show. And the name of the skit used to be Twin Peaks. Was it just Twin Peaks, or was it some, just Twin Peaks?
It was our take on Twin Peaks.
It was a great skit, too. We all did a great job, and we loved it so much that we're having a sequel, and then what do you call that when they make a third one?
A trilogy.
And we're having a third one. So it's great. So watch for that. Actually, you don't have to watch for it, because this is the first part.
Yeah.
All right.
This is what we filmed back in winter. February, March. No, we didn't film it.
I'm lying.
February or March. And I hope you all enjoy it. So that'll be on the show later on. But first, because it was only a half hour, we have to fill up this 90-minute spot. So
yes,
we're going to run around naked all day. And, you know.
Scare the viewers.
Did I tell you that story?
No.
That story about what happened?
No. Nope. What happened?
Yeah, I can believe this.
No.
What else? How about that other story?
The other story?
The other story? There I am in the Congo. You know what happens? Every day, I get up, I go to work, you're bobbing and weaving. You know what I'm gonna do right now? I'm gonna count to 1 to 100 very fast. I'm gonna start off slow and do it fast. You ready for this?
Go ahead.
See how fast I can do it without screwing up.
Okay.
I know. There'll be a lot of editing from that monologue with all the swears in it.
I didn't swear, you swear.
No, I didn't. Carl swore.
No.
All the lights were not working and the camera wouldn't work, so I swore.
No.
Ready?
Go
ahead. One, ready? Good, because we have, coming up next, Weekend News with host, who's the host? Sean Connery.
Me!
Sean Connery, and his guest is Lyle Lovett. That's right, Lyle Lovett will tell us why he married Julia Roberts and why she married him, for that matter.
He was
that. Then we have Storytime. Whose story time is it this week?
Yours?
And then, yeah, you guys gotta make up the work you didn't do. Because then 8 weeks are off. Nah, it was only like a week or something. So shut up. You wanna my show, you moron? You shut up, you dude.
Shut up, boy.
Okay. Then we've got, let's see, we got Weekend News Part. No, we can't have Weekend News Part 2 yet. Yes, I think we do. Weekend News Part 2 with host Lawrence Dagny. What happened was Marlon Brando, the cue card boy screwed up Marlon Brando's cue cards. Whatever. And who, Dennis Hopper's hosting it? No, he's an outside reporter. Okay, I see. Okay, then we've got, if there's time, if we get that new camera by the time this airs, remotes. Part 3 of the comic campaign, or part 2 or 1, one of those things.
Yes.
We say, and then after that, we have the Murder After Dark movie itself, part one, which will be this week.
Yeah.
Then a sneak preview of what's coming up next week, which will be part two. And the week after, part three. The week after, our Halloween special two. That's right, our second year, second special. And then we finally go back to our normal schedule for about 4 weeks, because then we got the Christmas season.
Right.
Time's
right.
Today, it's everyone's favorite news source, Weekend News with Lawrence Degley. Filling in for Lawrence Degley is Sean Connery.
Okay.
book all right?
John Dewis, I'm Sean Connery. Tonight my guest is Lyle Lovett. So ladies and gentlemen, here he is, Lyle Lovett.
Thank you, Sean.
How you doing, Lyle? I've got a scout question. Why's your house so big?
Well, I didn't want to cut it.
That's very interesting. I was wondering another thing.
Yes.
How long did it take you to grow the hair that big? Let's just stop this and defer a moment.
Try this now.
Is this?
Do your voice below.
Okay, like
this. Grow the hair.
When I was young, like about six, I realized I didn't want to cut my hair. And for 43 years since then, I haven't cut it.
You know, I've got to say, I'm about to crack up laughing at so hard. Now.
Hey, if I were you, I wouldn't talk about hair.
That's not funny. I cannot believe I've washed on my hair. But, what happens if you go bald? What are you gonna do?
I think I'll have to buy a wig.
A wig? I like that look like that one. Oh, Lyle, do you? What inspired you to do that type of music?
Oh, when I was...
Sort of like a jazz type of a country thing.
Yeah. Well, it's funny you should say that, because when I was young, you know, I grew up listening to both jazz and country, so I fused them together as one.
That's very interesting. For one thing, I must say something.
Yeah.
You're married to the most beautiful girl in the world. How did you do that one? It does not seem possible. Wouldn't you do to get a nice chick like that? Someone who's, quite frankly, no offense to you, has got looks that are like looking at an ass.
Well, I really don't know.
For one thing, there's a shut up. Just shut up. There was a study released earlier that said Julia Roberts found Abraham Lincoln, the President of the United States, 13th, was it 16th president? 13th, sounds right the first time. You expect them from Ireland. Anyways, there was a study said she had a crush on him when she was 5 years old. How is that possible?
I don't know.
If we were to put a beard on you, I'd bet you'd look just like him.
Oh, I probably...
Could you get the newspaper?
Sure.
Go over there and get the paper.
Sure.
I'm Sean Connery, you might remember me for some movies as James Bond. When James Bond, I didn't have no mustache. Thank you very much. You know, all the girls find me irresistible. That's why I'm interviewing you, because I don't understand how you are. I asked Julia Roberts out on a date before.
Look who's talking, Baldy.
What's that funny? The girls love the baldness. Alright, now what we're gonna do here is make a beard. Could you hold the microphone while I talk?
Sure.
Now, Lyle Lovett, will you sing us a song?
Sure, I will. This one's called Stand By Your Man.
I've got a problem. All right, Mike, it's starting to make my sick. Now let's put this
bed... Oh my God, it's so Connery!
Oh God! The women fuck, they're falling over me. That's disgusting. Now, I made the bed. Now, Julia Roberts... Yes.
If I can just ask you a question.
Ask me the question, you pig.
Why is it that women find you attractive?
Well, they find me attractive because I take order. I'm sensitive and sweet to them, and I'll never yell at them. And my mustache continues to fall over my face.
And you pick your nose a lot.
You do that. Now, let's just put this beard on and see if he does look like Abraham Lincoln. Oh, my God! I can't believe it! He does! No wonder why Roberts. Julia Roberts, the 81-year-old who cooks. Anyways, it's kind of fascinating. It's kind of fascinating how things like that turn out. Just, you know what's going on now?
Sean?
Yes.
Your mustache is falling.
What do you mean my mustache is falling off?
Your mustache is falling off.
That's impossible. Why? What would my mustache? Let me tell you a secret. A couple years ago, I was doing a film. It was Rising Sun. See, we started filming it a few years ago with Wesley Snipes. Anyway. What happened was...
Hey!
Ah! Ah! Ah, damn it! How much that fell off? Can you get that, please? Thank you very much.
You're a man.
This is a goddamn showroom here. I think we've got a circus going on.
I'm letting hold you closer to you.
There we go. Now, Lyle Lovett, how's your relationship with Julia Roberts?
Me and Julia get along well. That's why you're married to your crowd.
Now,
I'd like to say something to you, Sean.
Yes, would you like to say that, Lyle?
I don't know if you knew this.
Yes.
But I'm an expert at karate.
Ah, but of course you are, dear. Ah, you know something? I found the brick for the 20th century and I've lost it. Right now. There's another movie I was in with Alec Baldwin called Hunt for Red October.
Yes.
Did you ever watch that movie, Lyle?
Yes, me and Julia watched it once while we were in bed.
God, God! You actually found sex with Julia Roberts. How was that? She's got one firm body.
Absolutely. It was so surprising that she'd find someone like me attractive. We were filming The Player.
Yeah, that's what I thought, The Player. You know, I was up for a role on that, but Dean Stockwell took it instead.
Yeah, so we were filming The Player, and she came over to me, and she said that she found me attractive, and of course I thought she was lying, because people do that to me, you know, with my head.
That's funny. So, you look like a retarded person when you laugh like that.
Sorry, Jim.
Well, we've got just a few minutes left.
Okay, I just wanted to finish the story. So then, you know, we went out, and after that, I got married soon after.
Now, did you have sex before you married or after? Because, you know, Julia Roberts is one of those sticklers for a good marriage.
Yes, we had head.
That is disgusting. Well, Lovett, I thought you were a clean Simon, but you'd say such a disgusting thing like that. You look like Herman Munster.
I know, I usually am sorry, Sean, but Julia and me, our relationship has made me be able to talk in front of people much, much more.
Now, one more thing, well, I love it. You look like a pencil eraser. Would you like fries with that? Would you cover some fries with that?
No, thanks, Sean.
All right, then.
Well, be going.
Well, that wraps it up for Weekend News.
Thank
you. So you and Julia are happy then?
Thank you.
That's very good. I'm Sean Connery, filling in for just anybody who's been here. This is Weekend News. There's strangulations going on outside there. Yes. They're strangling Paul.
Thank you,
Lyle Lovett. By the way, is this real?
Yes.
Thank you very much, Lyle. It was a pleasure to have you here today. Who's that? That's fake, because I don't believe it is half fake. Now, Lyle Lovett, who's coming up on the next Weekend News? Used to host in the storyline on that
Marlon
one.
Marlon Brando and
Marlon Brando.
Lawrence Stegley.
Lawrence Stegley will be hosting it.
Yes.
Marlon Brando's his guest.
Yes.
We've got Cue Card Boy.
Yep.
Who, and an interview with Cue Card Boy will be who? That's disgusting, you pig.
Dennis Hopper.
Dennis Hopper will be interviewing. Would you please stop that, okay? Before I kick your ass.
The studio.
I'm gonna go. I'll see you later. Thanks for watching Weekend News. I'm Sean Connery. Go to my movie Rising Sun with Wesley Snipes. You know, it's a big hit. See you later. Goodbye. Story time coming.
And now, Comedy After Dark presents Storytime. This week's episode is written, produced, and directed by Jay Tucker and Paul Mele. And now, Storytime.
So it like starts out with me telling the story.
It fucking sounds just like you.
Won't you be my neighbor?
Okay, this is story time. Go to the story, I guess. Okay, that was good.
That was cool.
Story. Yeah, go to the story.
Where's the story?
Story. It starts out with me and Paul, we kind of break out of jail. So break out of jail and like run or something.
Okay. You're Jay.
Huh?
What?
No, you and me are in jail. We are inmates. We break out.
You said he was Jay.
Yeah, he's Jay.
Alright.
Jay.
Alright, what's going on here?
Okay, run. You're running through the I'm
Okay, here we go, here we go.
Here we go.
We're
running
out.
Okay.
I had just broken out of jail.
Thank God we got out!
Okay, we were running through the woods. Running through the woods for like... We're running through the woods for what seemed like hours. Then it got dark out. So we camped out. We made a tent and we camped out. Okay, finally we fell asleep. Okay.
What the? What's that?
The next morning, I wake up only to find someone had stolen my bagel.
What's the matter, man? You lost your bagel?
So I'm running, so I get up. In a fit of rage, I smash down a tree. I'm going to find my bagel, I think, no matter how long it takes me.
I'll help you, man.
But
it went that way.
I realize on fall that his nipples had rotten out. But I put that aside me.
Okay.
There were more important things to do. My bagel had been stolen.
Come on, let's find your bagel, Jerry.
So, I ran. We ran. We ran into town. Ran into town. Searched every single house and beat up everybody.
Just come on, let's kick it.
Trying to find my bagel. On the way, saw a couple nice looking girls. So we beat them up too.
Oh, yeah.
With a couple of whips and stuff. The regular sort of masochistic stuff. But then we see behind us two police officers. One was the warden.
Pigs! God! Freeze!
So we ran.
All right, you two!
I punched one in the face and he turned into a pig and ran off. But Paul got captured and taken back, but I ran. I ran. I was determined to find that bagel. So, bagel-less and partnerless, I went on. Walked all the way across the country. But finally, waiting there on the sidewalk, deteriorated, fuzzy, in a cardboard box, I found my bagel. I was so overjoyed, but I didn't. And burped. So I turned myself in. Even though I was on death row, I was so happy I found my bagel, I didn't care.
Okay, well, that's my story. I'm dead on the ground.
Okay, so now Paul, you're right next.
Oh, that was pretty good.
Okay.
I meant it to be stupid.
Okay. Watch.
Mike.
All right. Okay.
You want me, Mike, you get this off the tripod or something like that? Because when.
Ready, woman.
Now, from Studio One in Northern Connecticut, it's Connery at the Dock, starring Mike Burke. Also with Carl Peterson. The After Dark band is Paul Mele and Jason Tucker. Plus me, Albert David. And now, turn up your lights, turn up your sets, snuggle up and get cozy. Here's Mike Burke.
Oh, shit.
Thank you. All right. This week on the show, we've got All right. This week, we're going to be talking about old people and the way... Shut up! All right. I can't think of any! All right, let's bring in a guest. This is my guest, Jay Tucker. Come on, give Jay a hand. Okay, so...
Jay.
How's life?
Sucks.
Okay. Okay. Now, when you go to school every day,
I'm stupid.
Thank you. This is my show now, isn't it? But
it's been your show this whole time.
No. I can't handle it.
Well, you started this show.
I can't handle it.
Who did you think it was?
I don't know. Maybe I'm losing it. Maybe. No. No, it's you. You're the weird ones. I'm normal, damn it! I'm normal! I'm normal! We got a great show today. We'll be back right after this.
I'm a big fan. So how are you today?
I'm a little pissed off. Someone made me look like a machine.